Good morning. So here we are, another year of online celebration of Christmas. It's sad that we cannot be together, but it's joyful that we can put this program together for you and for your families that are watching and for all of us in the school. This is Christmas time. It's a very special time of the year where we celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. And that story is being told in a very different format this time. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the Christmas program. But before that, let's pray. Father, we thank you this morning for your presence. We thank you for the opportunity that you give to us to celebrate Christmas together with all of the people that are viewing this program right now. We pray, Lord, that you will help them to really understand the meaning of Christmas. Father, we pray that you will be with every single one of these people that are watching, be their parents, be the students, be the staff, be the family of the staff. Father, we pray that you will give hope, that you will provide assurance that you love them. Father, we pray that this program will be a great blessing to each and every one of us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. So enjoy the program.
We have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er. dong, merrily on high, in heaven the bells are ringing. Ding dong, merrily the sky is ringed with angels singing. Steeple bells be swung, and yo 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 by priest and people sung. Beautifully rhyme your eve-time song is singers.
Good morning, bonjour, namaste everyone. I'm your host Anish from MCS and I'm here for the most awaited program of the year, MCS Christmas Celebration 2021. And I'm joined by my co-host Ishan and our friends from Dwarka, Mrs. Margaret and Mahima.
It's so good to have you all online this morning. We have people logging in from Vasant Kunj, Dwarka, Rajouri Garden, Motibagh, Noida, Bamnoli, 66 Dwarka, Vikaspuri, Gurugram and Nazafgarh.
And don't forget our international participants. They are also logging in from Dubai, Africa and from France as well.
Warm welcome to all of you. Let's start the program.
Hey, hold on. We have teachers too joining with us.
Of course, yes. Hey friends, let's buzz the teachers group. Just type a Merry Christmas in your official teachers group and post it there.
A final welcome everyone. Today on our show Connected With Us Online, we have a wide range of guests spread across our history. Allow me to introduce them to you. Garden Eden. Well, Mr. Adam, would you like to answer this question?
I was kind of expecting that question. Well, it's a long story and a pretty sad one too. We messed up real bad. I mean, Eve and I. It started like a dream, a perfect destination. The lovely blooms, the chirping birds perching on fruit trees. We had no lack. No worries, no bills. Life was sorted. Let me take you to the very beginning, the Genesis.
In the beginning,
God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was formless and empty, and darkness covered the face of the earth. The Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. God said,
"Let there be light."
And there was light. And God saw that the light was good. He separated the light from the darkness and called the light day and the darkness night.
Let there be a space between the waters to separate the waters of the heavens from the waters of the earth.
And God created the sky. God said,
"Let the waters beneath the sky flow together into one place, so dry ground may appear."
And this is what happened. He called the dry ground land, and the waters seas. And God saw it was good. Then God said,
"Let the land produce vegetation, every sort of seed-bearing plant, and trees that grow seed-bearing fruit."
And God saw it was good. Then God said,
"Let the lights appear in the sky to separate the day from the night. Let them be signs to mark the seasons, days, and years."
He created the sun to rule the day, the moon and stars to rule the night. And God saw that it was good. Then God said,
"Let the waters be filled with living creatures, and let the birds fly across the sky."
So God created great sea creatures and birds according to their kind, and creatures that move on land according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said,
"Let us make man in our image, in our likeness, and let them have dominion over all the living creatures of the world."
So God created man in his own image. Male and female, he created them. And God said,
"Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over all living things that move on the earth. You may freely eat of every tree of the garden. Do not eat of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, for in the day that you eat of it, you will surely die."
God just enjoyed the fellowship with the man and woman he had created. They used to meet every day, walk and talk, and spend time with each other. But there was someone who was displeased with the closeness between God and man. He wanted to separate man from God and hatched a plan to tempt them into disobeying God's only commandment. "Do not eat of the tree of knowledge of good and evil." But they disobeyed. This is how a man drew away from God's perfect plan and purpose for his life. When they realized what they had done, they were ashamed and hid themselves.
"Adam, where are you? What have you done? Have you eaten from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from?"
This is how sin, sickness, poverty, pain, and death entered a beautiful world. Because of man's disobedience, the relationship between God and man was broken. God, still being gracious, clothed them, and God gave them a promise of forgiveness
and peace with him through his only Son, Jesus, whom he will send into this world to restore the broken relationship.
Oh, Mr. Adam, you lost out on such a lifetime opportunity because of your disobedience. Well, disobedience against God has always been a problem for mankind. What do you think, ma'am?
Yes, it is this sin that separates us from all the good that God had planned for us. But we see that there is also a promise of forgiveness and peace with God.
Absolutely. And that was made possible through the obedience of one man, the Lord Jesus Christ, who came down from heaven to dwell among us.
Did you know? Jesus was a descendant of Father Abraham, 42 generations down the line.
Wow, that's quite a Matthew Salt right there. I'm impressed.
Chill. Mr. Matthew mentions it in the first chapter of his book. That's why you need to read the scripture.
Well, what I know is that he passed the toughest examination in all of history. Neat, cat, Matt, all seem like a cakewalk compared to his examination. But before we continue, let's take a short break.
Welcome back to the Christmas Celebration 2021. If you have just tuned in, we were talking about Father Abraham and the toughest test he cleared. It's time now to hear from the legend himself.
Thank you for those kind words, children. God's word is forever true. He did make me a father of many nations. But the test? The test was indeed a difficult one. But I had already made up my mind. Come what may, I will always believe in God. And my obedience pleased him. His voice still echoes in my ears.
Abraham loved God more than anything else in this world. He was a friend of God.
Abraham, I will bless you and make your name great. I will make you a great nation. All the people of the earth shall be blessed in you.
God, how could that be possible? I don't have any children.
But Abraham always believed in the goodness of God. Though many years went by, Abraham was 99 years old. Still, he had no child of his own. Our God is a promise-keeping God, and nothing is impossible for him. So when Abraham was 100 years old, God blessed him and Sarah with a baby boy named Isaac.
Father Abraham, Oh wow! What a step of obedience, and what an amazing promise of God. Nations are being blessed through one man, Abraham.
Yes, both Jews and non-Jews who believe in the Lord Jesus, regardless of any race, any color, any tribe, and any tongue.
That's so encouraging. God thought of us even before we were born.
Yes, He is an omniscient and all-knowing God. In fact, many people foretold the coming of Jesus, our Savior, centuries before He was born.
Yes, I know. Many of these are recorded in the Bible. And they are called future tellers. Now, fortune tellers. Like Mr. Isaiah, we have him too as one of our guests, right?
Did I just hear fortune teller? Oh, that's such an insult. Don't you know, I'm a prophet of the living God. I deliver God's message to people.
Yes, prophet, that's the word.
Does God really speak to you? How do you hear God's voice? Is it like a thunder? Is it like a bang? Please tell me.
Okay then, let me tell you my story.
Years before the birth of Lord Jesus, the kingdom of Israel was torn apart. A major portion had gone into captivity, while the kingdom of Judah was caught up in worship of false gods.
Judah was reigned by an evil king named Ahaz, who was a wicked man.
It was at this time that God chose a messenger, Isaiah, to go and tell his people to stop sinning and come back to him. One day, Isaiah was in the temple praying to God.
Oh God, how beautiful is your temple, and how precious are your commands. But your people, they have sinned against you. They have forgotten all the good things you have done for them.
What is happening? Where am I? Am I dreaming? No, this is for real. Who is this?
Ah, the Lord God, I am doomed, for I have seen the Most Holy One, and I am a sinful man. I live among sinners, but God, please have mercy. Please forgive me.
Isaiah, the Lord God forgives all your sins.
Whom shall I send? Who will go for me to tell the people of Israel my message?
Here am I, O Lord. Send me.
It's a difficult task. Though you would warn them, yet the people would not listen. Because of their rebellion, they would go into exile. But I will also give you a message of hope. I will not punish them forever. I will send a new king to restore my creation back to me.
The next day itself, Isaiah began to tell people what God said. Day in and day out, he warned them and told them the sad news.
Repent, else you will be punished. You have sinned against God. Repent of your ways and obey God.
But no, people didn't return to God. Instead, they laughed and made fun of Isaiah.
Ah! Look at this madman! What is he saying, crazy fellow?
Ah, forget him. He keeps blabbering. Let us continue our celebration.
And then it all happened as God had said. Isaiah told the truth, but the people of God did not listen. God took his protection away from them, and the Babylonians conquered Israel. They carried away thousands of Israelites and made them into slaves. The Israelites were dragged away from their own country in ropes and chains. People were discouraged and depressed. It was at this time that God gave them a message of hope.
The good news is, a king is coming, not a sinful one like you're used to. This king will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace, there will be no end. He will establish his kingdom with justice and with righteousness from this time forth and forevermore.
This was exactly what the people had longed for. Deliverance was coming. Someday this king would break onto the scene and make everything right again. And his name would be Jesus.
What a loving God. Despite the rebellion, he still gave a promise of hope for his people.
This is so true for our life stories even today, where we choose to rebel against God and go on our own ways. But he is always willing to forgive us and bring us back to him. What great love.
Oh, I remember Mr. Alfred is with us today. Let's shoot this question to him. Sir, have you come across anyone who has experienced God's love and his forgiveness?
Oh, so many, I would say. In fact, we see a reflection of this love in the very life story of our beloved Sir Dr. V.K. Williams. Hey, let's hear it in his own words.
V.K. Williams tab sirf 4 saal ke the jab unke pita ki mrityu hui aur unki maa nurse training ke liye chali gayi. Isliye V.K. Williams और उनके छोटे भाई बहन अपनी दादी और मामा के पास आ गए।
I could not get that love of the father or the love of the mother. It was very strict discipline.
जब बीके विलियम्स 9 साल के थे, तो वो एक चर्च गए। प्रीचर ने जो कुछ कहा, उससे वो हैरान रह गए।
मुझे ये आयत सुनाई दी, वो प्रचारक प्रचार कर रहा था, क्योंकि परमेश्वर ने जगत से इतना प्यार किया कि उसने अपने इकलौता पुत्र दिया कि जो कोई उस पर विश्वास करे वो नाश ना हो पर अनंत जीवन पाए। When I heard this word love, first time I heard in my life, and because this was the word in Bible, so I began to read the Bible.
उन्होंने ये तो सुना कि प्रभु उन्हें प्यार करते हैं, लेकिन वो इस प्यार को समझ नहीं सके। जब वो 14 साल के थे, तो बहुत गंभीर रूप से बीमार पड़े, और उन्हें एक सपना आया, जिसने उन्हें बहुत गहराई तक प्रभावित किया।
मैंने देखा कि लाखों लोग वो भाग रहे हैं और सामने एक बड़ी झील है आग की। बड़ा भयानक दृश्य था। It was a very frightening sight. और मैंने प्रार्थना की, हे प्रभु, मुझे आप उस नरक से बचा ले। I don't want to go there.
वो बीमारी से तो ठीक हो गए, लेकिन इस सपने को नहीं भुला सके। वो नरक के ख्याल से डर गए और उन्हें ये भय लगने लगा कि शायद परमेश्वर उन्हें किसी बात के लिए सजा दे सकते हैं।
I was always afraid of death. I did not have a witness within my heart. मेरे हृदय में ये गवाही नहीं थी कि मैं परमेश्वर का पुत्र हूँ। मुझे तो सिर्फ परमेश्वर का डर लगता था।
जब वीके विलियम्स वयस्क हुए, तो वो एक ईसाई बन गए। वो उन सिद्धांतों का पालन करने लगे जो उनके मुताबिक ईसाई जिम्मेदारियाँ थी, क्योंकि अब भी उन्हें परमेश्वर की सजा का डर था। लेकिन 52 साल की उम्र में उन्हें जीवन बदल देने वाला एक अनुभव हुआ।
मैं अपने कमरे में बैठा हुआ अप्रैल 76 में सोच रहा था कि मैं एक बहुत अच्छा मसीही हूँ, that I am a good Christian, क्योंकि मैं बाइबल 2.5 घंटे पढ़ता हूँ रोज, मैं प्रार्थना करता हूँ, मैं हर गिरजाघर की मीटिंग में जाता हूँ, मैं लोगों को दान देता हूँ और एक परुष के भय में जीवन बिता रहा हूँ। तब अचानक से एक आवाज मुझे आई कि मेरी सबसे बड़ी आज्ञा कौन सी है।
बीके विलियम्स ने बाइबल पढ़ी थी, इसलिए उन्होंने फौरन जवाब दे दिया।
मैंने कहा, प्रभु आपकी सबसे बड़ी आज्ञा है परमेश्वर को सारे तन सारे मन सारे धन से प्रेम का।
इस आवाज ने उनसे और सवाल पूछे।
सेकंड क्वेश्चन केम, हैव यू ब्रोकन माय ग्रेटेस्ट कमांडमेंट। मैंने कहा, प्रभु मैं आपसे प्रेम नहीं करता, मुझे आपका डर लगता है। तीसरा प्रश्न आया, जो मेरी सबसे बड़ी आज्ञा तोड़ता है वो कैसा बड़ा पापी है। देन आई रियलाइज दैट आई वाज द ग्रेटेस्ट सिनर, सो आई नेल डाउन एंड प्रेड, आई क्राइड।
उन्होंने बरसों तक बाइबल पढ़ी थी और चर्च जाते रहे थे, लेकिन पहली बार उन्हें प्रभु का प्यार और शांति महसूस हुई, लेकिन अब भी उनके मन में कुछ सवाल थे।
पर हाँ, एक प्रश्न रह गया कि मैं सोच रहा था ये परमेश्वर कैसा है जिसने कि बिना मुझे सजा दिए हुए मेरे पाप माफ कर दिए।
अगले कुछ दिनों के दौरान उन्हें अपने सवालों के जवाब मिलने शुरू हो गए।
फोर्थ डे when I was reading the Bible, I came across 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 24. Christ himself carried our sins in his own body on the cross so that we might die to sin and live for righteousness. It is by his wounds that you have been healed. See, that changed my life. Ki God really loved men. He is a righteous God. He is a just God. He did not forgive my sin, just sitting millions of miles away. But he paid the penalty of my sin. Now I realize that my God loves me. कि मेरा परमेश्वर मुझको बहुत प्यार करता है।
My friends, indeed, what a beautiful testimony of someone who knows the Lord Jesus Christ as his own personal Lord and Savior. Indeed, we miss our beloved and our very dear respectful Mr. V.K. Williams. What a man of God he was. And what a beautiful lesson of forgiveness. Indeed, what a lesson of forgiveness. It's so difficult to forgive someone, especially when you are right and the other person is wrong, and yet for the right, you have to face all this problem. My friends, it is difficult to forgive. But what a beautiful example of God's special forgiveness we see from the cross. My friends, all I can tell you as you're getting into this season of festivity and Christmas and all the jingle bingle and all that is around it and all the cakes, all the new clothes and all the lights and all the hustle and the bustle and all the music, and between all of this, in this grandeur and all the grand celebrations of Christmas, I hope we are not forgetting the Christ in the Christmas. Or have we made it Xmas? Khatam. Xmas. You cross it out. Are you crossing Christ out? Friends, there is no Christmas if there is no Christ. He came. Friends, I remember a beautiful story of a man who was a wayward person, a prodigal, a person who left his beloved father many years back. The father pleaded with him that don't leave the home, don't go the wrong way, don't get into wrong company, leave these wrong friends. He said, no, it's my life. I would like to do it my own way. And he left his father and went to a different far-off city. And there he wasted his life. He got into wrong company, he got into all sorts of vices, whether it be drinking or smoking or drugs and all these rotten things he got into. These evil things. And that destroyed him completely. Many years went by. His life was absolutely on the rocks and he felt that life is not worth the living. He was completely depressed and dejected in life. He comes back to his hometown and there one night he books a cab and he calls this Uber person and he comes. It's late night, it's Christmas Eve, my friends. People are with their families, they're rejoicing, they're having dinners, they're singing carols, they're praying, they're worshipping God. It's a beautiful festival of festivity. And my friends, this man all alone, with an unshaven face, ruffled hair, and completely dejected, lost all hope, he calls a taxi. And this cab driver comes, and the cab driver, he says, take me to a bridge in the city, which was over a river. And there, as he goes, the taxi driver was a very fine Christian, a God-fearing man. He felt there is some problem. There is a problem. Because he saw it in his eyes that he was lost. He was hopeless, depressed, dejected. Friends, are you feeling the same? I do not know who I'm speaking to today, but I speak to your heart today. Are you feeling dejected, discouraged, hopeless? If you feel you have no strength, there may be many circumstances that you're going through. There may be many exams that you have to face, but you're very sad. Perhaps thinking to quit and give up, to throw the towel in. No. Please don't. This man went to he was dropped at the river, a bridge, and there this taxi person dropped him. He said, he gave him the money. He says, keep the change, I don't need it. I won't be needing it after tonight. And that rang a bell in the mind and heart of the taxi driver. He says, perhaps this man is committing suicide. But as he was going back, something in his heart told him, you know what's going to happen and still you're going riding away. He takes a U-turn. He dashes back to that spot and he finds him right at the railing. And he says, stop, sir. Give me one chance to speak with you. With great difficulty, he convinces him to sit in his cab. And he says, do you have a family? He says, yes. My father lives in the same town. He says, please, call your father. I'm sure at Christmas he will like to meet you. He says, no, I left my father. I'm a disgrace to the family. I've done all the sins and all the wickedness in my life. No one loves me, he said. No one loves me. No one. He says, no, give him one chance. Call him. So he takes the phone and reluctantly, because the driver pleaded with him, he calls the number, but it goes on an answering machine. And he says, Father, I'm in town. I wanted to meet you. If you still love me, if you have forgiven me, just I'll pass by our home. And if you can keep the front door open and the porch light on, I will come to know that you have forgiven me and I can come back home. I'll pass by in a few minutes, the home. I'm in a taxi. The father did not respond because it went to an answering machine. But friends, he was getting scared. As they went through the by lanes and lanes and the crossings, he saw all the festivity around, the beautiful lights, the decorated malls and the shopping complexes and people's carol singing from churches he heard. Oh, he was wondering whether or not his father will keep the door open or not. He was scared. He was wondering, will it happen or not? Will that light be on or will the door be open? Friends, his heartbeat started beating fast. As they neared the place, the taxi guy said, is this the lane? He says, yes, this is the lane. He was breathing heavy. And the taxi driver was pleading to God and making this prayer, Father God, please, may the light be on and the door be open and he may go back to his home. It may be a return for him, a new life for him. Friends, I know what you're thinking. I know what you're thinking. I'm sure nearly all of you have thought that the door will be open, the front door, and the light will be on. But friends, I want to just hold on to that suspense, and I want to show you a clip from the movie so that you can see this moment, which I can't express. By the way, you all are wrong. Yes, that one light was not on and that one door was not open. Let's see what really happened when he took that turn on that lane where his house, his father's house was. Let's see what happened.
That it?
Heart, what forgiveness, what joy, what love we see here, my friends. The doors were open, every single light, whether every single lamp he had, he put it out. Every light was open. Oh, the house was as bright as it could be. And friends, on that Christmas Eve, this man returned back home. He came back home, and oh, what an embrace that would have been. Oh, what joy to the family it would have been. The prodigal has returned. My son has returned. He was lost, but he is found. I thought he was dead, but he's alive. Friends, all I want to tell you, the Father forgave him. Friends, there is a heavenly Father. There's a Savior God who came into this world. You know why he came? We read that in Luke chapter 19. Please read it. It's a beautiful chapter on a man called Zacchaeus. And there the Lord Jesus Christ said, I have come. I have come. I have come. He has come. We remember his coming into this world. He came. He came. God became man. It's a great mystery. We cannot fathom it, cannot understand it, can't comprehend how God, the maker of the universe, the King of glory, the God, became man, was born in a manger. He took on humanity, meekness and deity together, manhood and kingship together, Godhead together. We cannot understand. It's a great mystery. The only one reason when God became man, the Bible gives. One reason. It defies comprehension and intellect. It is because he loves you. For God so loved the world. John chapter 3 verse 13. John 3:16. Sorry. For God so loved the world. So loved the world. So loved Alfred. So loved you. That he gave. He came. He gave. He died on the cross. He shed his blood and he rose again on the third day. He came to save us from our sins. Jesus means Savior. The one who will save you from your sins. And Christ means the anointed one, the sent one. He came. God became man. Great mystery. We cannot understand. But he came to save you and to save me. from our sins. And how did he do it? He took our penalty. He died on the cross. He shed his blood. He was buried. But on the third day, he rose from the dead. He's a living one. He's the risen one. He's alive. He went alive into heaven. And he's coming back again, but not as a little baby in a manger, but one day as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, my friend. But today, he's waiting. He keeps the door open. He's kept the door open. He's kept every light of opportunity open. He beckons you, come unto me. All who labor and are heavy laden with the burden of sin, come unto me and I will give you rest. Friends, he is waiting. This Christmas, he is willing to forgive you of all your sins. He died for your sins. No one has done it. No one. And no one rose from the dead. Friends, he came to seek and to save those who were lost in sin. I was one of them. The Bible says all have sinned. All have fallen short of his glory. We have all fallen short of his standard, but he still loves us. Oh, he loves us. He loves us. He loves you. He loves you. He loves you. The door is open. Come back to him. Even this Christmas, come back to him. Come back to him. God bless you.
Was beautifully illustrated, Alfred, sir. Anyone can receive this love and forgiveness of God in their life. You just need to believe it and receive it.
We have heard so much today about the birth of the Lord Jesus. I wish we could experience it firsthand with Mary and Joseph themselves.
My dear, your wish just came true. Here's the story just for you.
Star, you're looking nice and bright this evening.
Thank you, old star. I've been working on a shiny net.
Good job. And this is a great night for us all to look our best.
Why is that?
Because it's Christmas.
Yay! Huh, what's Christmas?
You don't know about Christmas? Oh, that's right. You're a brand new star. This is your very first Christmas.
Yes. Is it your first Christmas too?
Oh no. I've seen over 2,000 of them.
Wow, 2,000? Is that a lot?
Well, yes, it is. In fact, I am old enough to tell you about the very first Christmas, and I can explain why we still celebrate it even after all these years.
Oh, please do. I want to hear all about it.
Okay, to start with, we have to go and visit a little place called Nazareth.
Oh, who's that pretty lady?
That's Mary. She's a young girl, pledged to be married to a man named Joseph.
Who's that other guy? He's all shiny like us.
That's Gabriel. He's an angel. He has come to talk to Mary. Let's listen.
An angel came from heaven. Name was Jesus. The baby's name was Jesus.
What can I say? I will submit to his will.
Where is the angel going now?
Angel Gabriel is going to visit Joseph.
An angel came from heaven, from heaven, from heaven. An angel came from heaven to bring good news. He came to see Joseph, he came to see Joseph, he came to see Joseph to bring good news. He said you'll have a baby, a baby, a baby. He said you'll have a baby to bring good news. The baby's name was Jesus, the baby's name was Jesus, the baby's name was Jesus, to bring good news.
All this took place as a fulfillment of the prophecy. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel. Oh, and the name Emmanuel means God with us.
Wow, that's a great name. Where are Joseph and Mary going now? I can see them riding a donkey and going somewhere.
They are going to a little town called Bethlehem.
Special night,
baby Jesus was born. The animals did a day, sang a song for his birthday. And this is what they sang. They say, ba 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 ba. Thank you God for baby Jesus. Ba 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 ba. Jesus is born. Meow, 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 meow. Thank you, God, for baby Jesus. Meow, 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 meow. Baby Jesus is born. Oh, what a special night. Baby Jesus was born. The animals did a day. Sang a song for his birthday. And this is what they sang. They say, hee-ho, hee-ho, hee-ho-ho. Thank you, God, for baby Jesus. Hee-ho, hee-ho, hee-ho-ho. Baby Jesus is born. Boom, 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 boom. Thank you, God, for baby Jesus. Boom, 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 boom. Baby Jesus is born.
Oh, what a cute little baby. What did they name him?
They have named him Jesus, which means the Lord saves.
Oh, look, I think they want to sing again.
Yeah, they do that a lot at Christmas time. You'll get used to it.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. Down to the town, there's someone to be found. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Search for the boy who will bring us all joy. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. We're the shepherds and here's our plan. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Find baby Jesus in Bethlehem. Sat in the fields with our flocks that night. The angel came, it was such a fright. Don't be afraid, he said, good news, it's joy for all of you. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger and worshipped him.
Ah, so this is the story of first Christmas.
Yes.
That's wonderful. Is that the whole story?
No, there's more to the story. Oh, I saw it all. From up here in the sky, I announced the birth of this Messiah and led the wise men to the Savior of this world.
Really? You are the new star that appeared that night?
Yes, I am. This story is over 2,000 years old, but it is still as true today as it was on that very first Christmas day. And that's why we still celebrate Christmas.
That's amazing. Thank you for telling me the story. I think I will shine a little more brighter now that I know all of this.
That was quite interesting. I hope you all enjoyed it too. And thank you for being a part of this Christmas celebration.
That's it from all of us here at MCS. Hope to see you all soon at school. Till then, keep safe.
Have a good, happy and enjoyable time with your friends and family. Wish you all a blessed Christmas.
And a happy new year.
Shall we all close our eyes as we come to the end of this program and pray together? Heavenly Father, we thank you for the grace that you have shown us. Lord, we thank you for the children and all the staff who have participated in this wonderful event through which they have been able to show what Christmas really means to us, Lord. We thank you for the message that has been displayed through this various channels that we have used, various means, Lord. I pray that it will touch the heart of some people who have watched it, Lord, and they are blessed, Lord. So as we come to the end of this program, Lord, we pray that your grace will be upon each and every one of us. Bless us together as a family of the Mount Carmel Schools, Lord, as we look forward to this Christmas day that we can celebrate together. We thank you once again, and we pray all this in the most precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.